So let's take a look at the editor. First, how to navigate in the editor view. Press the right mouse button to rotate the view. Press the middle mouse button to move the view. Use the mouse scroll wheel to move in and out of the view. Press and hold the middle mouse button while clicking the right mouse button to recenter the view at the location of the pointer. Use the left mouse button to select objects in the view. Now let's look at the editor interface. Up here you have some menus. The file menu to create a new scene, to open a scene, save, and so forth. Then you have the edit menu, where you have the usual cut, copy, paste, select parent, duplicate, delete, and stuff like that. The view menu contains several options to hide and focus, collapse the hierarchy, and stuff like that. Next, you have the tools menu with a couple of special options. Windows, you have the layers, snap, search, and type filtering. And then last, you have the help menu, which contains help sections for all of the different parts of the editor. Let's take a look at the basic windows. This is the scene explorer. It holds the hierarchy of the whole scene. It always has this scene node at the top, and then all of the contents of the scene underneath it. So here is the ground plane, the brown box, the spawn point where the player spawns when the game is played, the sandbox script, the main script, and the environment. We will take a closer look at these in a future video. Then we have the properties window. The contents of the properties window depends on what node you have selected in the hierarchy. So for example, now I have the environment node selected. We have a lot of environment related properties here. If I select the ground box box, we have a set of other properties here. And then we have the layers window that can be used to create different layers that you can turn on and off when the level is loaded. It is also useful to hide certain things of the level while you're building. Apart from these three basic windows, we also have snap, where you can enter values for snapping when you move objects, and snapping when you're rotating objects. We have the search window that we'll go further into in a future video. And we have the type filtering window, which can be used to hide and show different kind of objects in the scene, which are prone to cluttering the view when working in the editor. All the windows can be moved around by clicking somewhere that isn't an entry field. And they can be resized by dragging the corner down here. In the Scene Explorer window, we also have a context-sensitive menu that can be accessed with the click of the right mouse button. If I right-click this node here, I get some commands related to this object, cut, copy, paste, etc. An important entry in this list is the new option, which opens up a new sub-window where you can create all the different nodes in the editor. So with this voxbox selected, I right-click, select new, and I select a new voxbox. As you can see, this new voxbox was added as a child to the previous voxbox. Let's rename these two for clarity. So now we have ground and its child, another voxbox. Now if I select the ground and move it around, by clicking and dragging these axes, the child, another voxbox, moves along with its parent. I can select another voxbox child, right-click it, and select Move Out of Parent. Now they move individually. The The selected object can be rotated by holding down Shift and dragging the axis. You can also hold R to rotate around the Y axis. With an object selected, you can press and hold the P key and then click somewhere in the scene to place the selected object at that point. And that's all for the editor overview.